Good morning from San Francisco. How's it going out there? I'm gonna start this stream kind of low and slow. I got dwarves to sculpt. I'm into it right now. Really, really in pinchy hell. I'm trying to catch up on some of this stuff. I'm trying a new approach where I'm just jumping right in. I got all of this artwork that Aaron has created lately. Maybe he'll show up in the chat today, I don't know. Yeah. Not feeling terribly talkative today. Maybe I'll loosen up later. Maybe it's the weather, it's kind of gray outside. It's winter, what do you expect? But, yeah, I'm trying to do this, shades and this hat, this, beard and mustache. Oh, you can't see it. I have an announcement to make today. I decided I'm not going to be streaming like this anymore. Not in this kind of format. I'm going to be changing my station, so I'm only streaming occasionally for structured stuff. Streaming while sculpting my regular thing doesn't really mesh with my style of getting things. I mean, it does kind of crack the whip for me and keep me in line. And gets me out of bed and gets me doing stuff early in the morning, but the way I work with my miniatures, the way I work on details, the way I try to focus on things, it doesn't work when I have other people around. I want it to. I want to socialize. I need to socialize. COVID and everything. It's really hard to focus without you guys. But I also can't focus with you. Not the way I need to. But for now, we're going to keep going. I know for a fact that Nightmare Games is looking forward to my streams where I work on the port-built trolls. And some other stuff is in line to be done online. And if I say I'm gonna do something, then I'm gonna do it. I'll hook it by crook. Of course, right now we're working on Space Dwarves. I'm just trying to throw together these details on this Space Dwarf all at once. Now, I'm doing these shoulder pads that you see here that have got the crisscross pattern on them, but then I'm going to also sculpt some more shoulder pads on top of these shoulder pads for some ideas that, you know, Aaron drew for the concept art for this line. But I am not in the zone. Not in the zone. And haven't been for quite some time. Okay. I can't wait for it to happen. I have to just get into it. Yeah, I haven't really put my mind to what the new format's going to be in the future. But I think it's going to be something along the lines of instructional videos. And videos that display finished works. Or at least, you know, I've got a line of figures and a lot of figures have been complete. And it's good for show and tell. You know, it's not just things that are being developed. It's... If I'm just streaming my development with you guys, all I ever really get accomplished is the basics, and I can't seem to get the nitty-gritties taken care of with you guys around. Not like it's your fault. I mean, I enjoy having you guys around. It's just, it's a self-awareness of what my style, how I approach my work, and how it works with the camera. I cannot let myself. Eldon, hey. I just can't let myself worry about my work, my detailing, and the camera at the same time. It's too much. Gotta do one thing or the other. This is so pinchy. When I say pinchy, what I mean is that you're just poking at this material and it looks like the material. It looks like chewing gum. I'm not creating details that create the illusion of a figure. Part of what happens if you work with material and it starts getting old too fast. It's curing as I'm working, so I have to just focus on the detail. How's it going over there in Scotland? You guys all right? Is it snowing with you now? It's snowing in Texas and stuff. It'll never snow here. All we get is gray. Dave Summers, that was a long time ago. He's mastered green stuff for quite some time now. Yeah, I mean, there's a certain look and feel to green stuff. Because of that property. Where it's kind of like pushing chewing gum around, dried chewing gum. But you should still, you know, achieve certain types of effects with it. To give the illusion of fabric, to give the illusion of, you know, leather straps, the illusion of flesh, the illusion of fur. Because if you can't, what's the what's the point? You went to Ralpartha? I didn't know you visited Ralpartha, Elton. What was that like? I've never visited Ralpartha. I've talked with the guys plenty of times. I've been in Ohio, but never visited Ralpartha before. Don't know what it's like there. Your dad lives in Cincinnati? That's news to me. Why does your dad live in Cincinnati? Next thing you're gonna tell me is that you also are a biker and you used to go riding with the Ralpartha gang. You are notorious bikers. Notorious. Went to Cincinnati to find a new wife. Had a biker jacket, but no bike. Sorry, I didn't mean to laugh at you. That's funny. I'm assuming that the music can be heard. I turned it down a lot for myself here. You can see there's a lack of details on the back. I'm mostly focused on the front at the moment. I'm just use, you know, the gauntlets of his work gloves. Should add a few details to make it apparent. And maybe I'll give it a cuff. Yeah. While I can. This, by the way, is one of the cutters. He's going to be brandishing a, kind of a halberd. A saw halberd. He's kind of this guy. Right here. More or less. And he's going to come into his own once I get the, once I get the pole arm attached. He also should have a secondary weapon and stuff on him too, but I'm not sure where. Under his... under here, perhaps? Between his elbow and his hip. Put a weapon right here. That'll come later. For now, I just want to get these, details of the first shoulder pad. And then I'm going to put a second pair of shoulder pads on here. I'm going to do it fresh, too. I'm not going to wait for this to dry. I'm just going to lay it right in there. As well as larger pouches. See these pouch shapes? They're too small. I'm going to make bigger ones over that. These are just like sub-shapes to hold it in place. I also want to put a little bit of something right here. You'll see. Yeah, I'm gonna bat around the idea of changing my stream format real soon. This format, it just doesn't catch on for me. I've tried, I've worked it for the past, time flies, I've been at this for like, what, 3 months now? But it's just never really working out for me, no matter what I do. Oh, everybody's on about the Skull and Crown. If you see him saying Bob Ollie, no, I'm trying not to do Bob. Yeah. We got mixed up signals here, where I'm looking at different things. The thing is that Bob Ollie really did put his stamp on some Space Dwarf stuff, and part of my mission is to avoid Bob Ollie. The Bob Ollie look. I'm not sure if we got a Bob Ollie Laz cutter. Honestly. Come on, clean. At a certain point, a lot of this stuff can't be done anymore. Material drying, hardening. These pinchy pinch. Yeah, Aaron's pretty much just like scribbling all kinds of things. Just throwing the spaghetti to the wall, see what sticks. Thomas Foss, he's putting in his 2 cents all the time. His job. In fact, I'm almost ready to take this thing to the next batch of fresh green stuff. Just stick it right on. Yeah. In fact, we might see Aaron come visit the chat in a little while. You're early. We're all early. Aaron might show up in the next tower, half hour or so. We might see Skull and Crown dropping in soon. Tuesday, they might have some business meetings they're attending right now for the game development. Just can't I can't concentrate on what I really need to be concentrating on when I'm streaming. No matter how hard I try, I just don't get used to it. And you know that I put a good effort into it. I've been trying really hard this past few months, but it's just not for me. I mean, I still intend to be streaming. I'm just gonna be scrambling for a less frequent stream. So I'll be doing maybe three or four streams a month, and the streams are gonna be much more focused. It's not just gonna be, hey, come watch me, screw around. It's gonna have better camera angles, better samples, more color. A real presentation kind of thing. I do intend to hold to the maxim that you have to make sure that you're you stay on schedule. You make a schedule and you keep it. That's one of the tricks to a successful stream for a lot of people, for most anybody. This regular thing just doesn't work for me. If I was like a larger scale sculptor, I could make this work. But not with the scale that I'm accustomed to working. My scale does not translate well enough for casual streaming. I'm too specialized. Oh, okay. Gotta try to put a little bit more love into this beard while I still can. Round and round circles I go. Driving me nuts. Recognize his finger. Oh no. I thought they were done over the weekend. I said as much with a few people. Darn. One of my problems, I suppose, is that I'm just no good at multitasking. When I'm sculpting miniatures, I need to focus. Streaming kind of robs me of that very, very fragile focus that I've got. I can smush it really hard and it still won't seam up because it's so old now. I'm about to mix some more green stuff in just a minute. Once I do the pauldrons on the pauldrons, this guy might really come into shape. I was thinking just a little while ago that some of these dwarf designs have more in common with the original orc raiders, space orc raiders, than they do old other dwarf designs. All right, let's give it a shot. It would help for me if I actually had a collection of space dwarves, but I don't have a single one. Never collected them. There is, in fact, a wonderful fellow out in England who is offering to send me an entire complete collection of them. But he's got other stuff to take care of first. I can wait years for a treat like that to come in now. Actually, it's a little bit of a problem. The crosshatch is something that Skull and Crown said they want to avoid if they can. Decided to put it on the these demi pauldrons. Because I know that I'm going to cover up most of it. I know, right? It's like getting all kinds of mixed signals on what I'm supposed to be doing with these guys. The state of my mind isn't really leaping to the right conclusions. I'm trying to fit the parts together. I mean, sometimes you'll get a client who like says he wants X, but with the you know J and a little bit of K thrown in. And you just look at the different sources and you stitch them together. In a situation like this, I don't know, for whatever reason, my head is not really cooperating with the creative juices you need to stitch the parts together and make them whole. I don't know, I'm doing my best. Because I'm just feeling very self-conscious this morning. The handguard, huh? It's a Bob Ollie thing? It would help if I had some Bob Ollie sculpts on my samples on hand. But then again, I have orders not to look at Bob Ollie samples. I am really a big Bob Ollie fan myself. Something I think I was mentioning in the stream before. It's like, it's a little difficult for me to avoid drifting towards Bob Ollie because I spent some time in the past few years deliberately focusing on his style and studying it. When you do that, you can internalize, you know, somebody else's way of doing things and make it part of your own. So there's a little bit of Bob Ollie in my work already. Where's my wax 5? There it is. Is that Bob Ollie, a link to Bob Ollie's work? Gotta try to get these demi pauldrons out a little bit more. Take the putty and just pull it out. Get it out there. And I have to have broad shoulders, that's part of the design. I'm gonna flatten this here and here to make room for the pauldrons that go over the pauldrons. Excuse me as I, like, experiment on the fly right here in front of you. I usually do this little technique trick for chins on creatures and stuff, pulling them out. In this case, I'm doing it for a pauldron that's starting to dry. Grab a hook underneath and pull it out. I'm sure Aaron did a job of just throwing together all sorts of details, his own inventions as well as those he's seen. In the end, these are fairly original designs. Okay. And So I'm doing the dwarves today, and I'm doing the dwarves on Thursday's stream as well. Assuming it doesn't get canceled or shortened like last week's. And but on Wednesday, it's going back to Nightmare Games Port Vealed Trolls. Because those are coming along, and there's good energy to be found in them. Goblin Civil War. Oh, that's right. Yeah, his goblins are great. I collect his goblins, his ogres, and his trolls. Just attaching some nice fresh putty onto old putty surfaces, building up on it. I gotta say, not having access to hatched patterns kind of slows me down. It's a very quick, creative shorthand for a texture to define, to describe a added armor. Anybody remember the old Bram Stoker's Dracula movie? I find myself, when I'm doing padded armor with just vertical lines in this for the padding, it ends up looking a little bit like Dracula's armor, that red armor that he wore in the beginning of the movie. Is bigger than the other one. I have to have them the same size. So I got a whole bunch of ammo pouches. What weapon is he going to be carrying that merits the ammo pouch? Oh no. The Gary Oldman, yeah, exactly. Gary Oldman, young, original, medieval Dracula armor. Citadel did a range of vampire knights using that texture? Huh. That doesn't surprise me. I might have even seen it, but never really noted it before. That would make sense. Sloppy now, but it's coming again. Middlehammer Blood Knights. That makes sense. Yeah. I remember that phase. They were really blowing up the whole vampires undead faction stuff. They're getting good sales out of it and everything. See them taking advantage of Gary Oldman armor. Making it work for them. Elton, are you sculpting with me right now at the same time? Or do you have that... Did you solve that lighting issue? Or you, can you sculpt while watching this at the same time? I can't imagine that being too hard to fix. Overcome. And I understand not wanting to work without good light. I feel half blind today just without the sun shining in the studio. One of the reasons that I enjoyed moving to San Francisco, you get more daylight to work by. I'm a big daylight sculptor. I don't get my colleagues who work in the dead of night. In a basement. Or a windowless room. You're just wilfing on the internet? I didn't know that word, wilfing. Prepare to wilf. Commence wilfing. Shadow underneath. It means just clicking links and seeing where it goes. I'd call that a rabbit hole. I suppose a rabbit hole is when you're following links that, you know, direct you along the way, a certain direction. I'm a little surprised that we don't have either the artist or the client here for Sally. Unless they should be lurking and they're actually working both their hands. Which happens. I was just doing that on somebody else's stream just an hour ago. They were sculpting a dragon, but all I could do was watch while I sculpted. A bad path. To work in the evening and during the night. Is Aaron is UK? I forget where Aaron lives. What time zone he's in. It's evening over there now, right? Well, this is a start. It's a little bit rough, but it's got the shape in. Kind of tooly, it's kind of pinchy. But it's also stout. Got a good amount of Avies epoxy in the blend, per usual with me. So I'll have the freedom to cut and carve some of this stuff and sand it in certain ways, make it look even better. Bad way to go, but I'll push and pull as I need to. You went to school with him but never actually met him. No, so you were at the same school but different classes? What school was that? Is he from Yorkshire? Are you from Yorkshire? Never asked you where you're from. I just assumed you were a Scotsman. Because that's where you are now. Please, tell us your life story on the internet for everybody to see. What harm could there be? Two schools combined? Huh. Like a desperate scheme to make ends meet? Well, there's that so far. A dwarf with a range of ammo pouches across his front. I might make his weapon and hands a separate bit. Don't really want to. might have no choice. Shades. Let me see. No, I'll keep the shades like this. I don't want them to get bug-eyed.
I roll it back to see it against the girl's crochet dress.
That's gonna cover it over with a gun holster. This might not. Well, I'll go ahead and detail this. Pinchy pinch. These pouches don't look very pouchy either. Honestly, what I really need right now, and I'm not gonna get for quite some time, is time in with my fellow sculptors in person. To actually just get to be with other artists in the same space and craft together. My wife is an artist, but she doesn't usually seem to like to work in the same room with me. We have different styles, of course. I sculpt, she draws. Back into it. Alton Waters says, you're actually from Yorkshire. Grew up in Buckinghamshire and the planned city of Milton Keynes. Oh, you moved there for Scotia Grendel? Wow. Once tried to move to Seattle for working at drawing a blank. WizKids. Tried going to Seattle to work at WizKids. Actually, Redmond, I think. I forget. No, just outside of Seattle. And I worked there for a stint, but they never put me on payroll. They kept paying me the same contract payments that I was making when I was working for them remotely. Like, why did I come here? Could have just done this work back at home. But I was already there. Ral Partha apprenticed sculptor program, but before you could submit your first sculpts, they were bought out by Hasbro, which ended that. Oh, back then, huh? Wow, that must have been a twist. Were you working with Bob Watts? Was he there at the time? I seem to remember that Bob Watts was one of the people who was there at the time that Hasbro bought them out. Actually, it wasn't Hasbro, it was, gosh, I forget now. I thought that was a Wizards of the Coast thing, which had yet to become Hasbro. Jeff, Dave Summers, and Tim Prowl was there? Tim, you were at Ral Partha? I'm confused. I can remember Tim saying something about being over in Seattle too at a different period of time. Was it Ral Partha? I know so little. I understand so little. I'm practically sleepwalking through life. I was talking about Bob Watts, I was talking about like a floor manager down in the casting room. I don't think Bob Watts does any of his own sculpting. As I remember, Bob Watts was working at Ral Partha in the period preceding PSR being bought out by Wizards of the Coast. He was like some sort of a production manager, floating from one corporation to the next. I remember scrambling to try to figure out who he was as I arrived at as a guest, Chaz Elliott back in, was that 98? 99 at Wizards of the Coast, as was had been spending the previous year throwing together a plan of how to do a new miniatures line for the Dungeons and Dragons license. Oh, it wasn't on site? Where was the sculptor program if it wasn't on site there in Ral Partha in Ohio? Did them at home. See, that's the thing. I don't want to be in a shop where I'm actually sculpting beside fellow sculptors. That's the kind of environment that would help me focus on getting better work done. Just being here online while still working in my own studio, it gets me to my table, it gets the tools in my hands, but it kind of takes me away mentally from my work. Notice how I'm going around and around in circles with these details? That doesn't happen when I'm just myself. This kind of merry-go-round detail pinching, this happens when I'm talking to people, not paying attention. I'd be already done with this phase now and on to the next finger if it wasn't. I'll go with this for now. Let's go on to the next one, shall we? Who we got? Oh, that's right. Let him just enjoy the spotlight for a little while. So this one is going to be a blaster. I'm going to do this figure right here. So our posture is already a little bit broad stanced. Jeez, I worked hard to have figures that are standing in a very static manner. Maybe I'll make him the second one. I don't know. This one's got such a nice head attached to him now. Because this blaster, he needs a custom head so that it fits within the... Oh, I don't know what you call this thing. Go ahead and get this on, shall we? Maybe the blaster's all about his arms and his pauldrons. I have to focus on. Looks terrible at this phase. I might have to do the face. We gotta figure out the volumes of the face and this thing that wraps around his face all at the same time. Was there a unit design-wise? Blaster looks terribly rotund. Built a blob here for the helmet that he's holding. Fine-tune it afterwards. I'm just making stuff up as I go along. Here we go. I'm reticent to make the dwarves too fat with the understructure. You know, I put on these layers, these details. Cumulatively, they create a lot of mass, and you don't have to make the under. You know, you see a dwarf figure that looks like he's fat. Don't sculpt him fat at the start. Keep him relatively lean. Chances are, a lot of the details you add onto it can help to make him look fat in the end. You start fat, and then you get really fat, and then you become just like a bowling ball. You don't want that. Well, I don't want that. Not for this. Now I'm working on the volumes all at once. I'm getting a really good feeling about them. But I'm going to be chasing these issues around. I'm going to give him armor boobs. He needs a chest. Not indicated in the art, but I'm going to put it in here. Alan's arrived. Hey Alan, how's France? Is it snowing with you yet? Oh, so we lose an Elton and we gain an Alan. Okay. No problem, Elton. Catch you later. It's a slow day here, Alan. I'm just pushing hard into doing Space Dwarves. Even though my work is a little pinchy and rough today, I'm not really feeling it. But these figures have to be done. Sometimes you have to get to work even though you're not feeling like work. Yeah, last week with frost in the morning, but no more this week. Oh well. Like we're not gonna get an errand today. Which is a pity because we're working with his artwork. Well anyway, what could he say? Wow, you're using my art! Yay! I'm gonna be sculpting these parts of pauldrons and other bits of armor. I'm gonna be like striving to make the parts intersect. They kind of collide a bit because the figure is just so small. Exactly. And it breaks my heart because I'm there for the project itself and theme. And Thomas Foss is an incredible guy. And his idea is great. I'm just been so distracted since November. And Space Dwarves is demanding a certain level of creativity that I'm just not able to dredge up half the time. Well, this figure that I'm doing right now is coming together. I think my point is that the kind of flow that I need to practice to get this work out, it's just not camera ready for you. You can't watch me do it. I can't film it. It doesn't happen that way. I want to show you what I do, but it's back and forth. It's all over the place. It's just me doing this a lot, and it's not good for camera work. Just trying to use the camera while doing it breaks the rhythm for me. It's a personal thing. Yeah, Alan, I was mentioning on the stream earlier, before you arrived, that I'm going to be changing my format in the future. I'm going to just do weekly instead of like two or three times a week. I'm just going to do one stream a week. But I'll make it a bigger stream, something like 4 or 5 hours, and it's going to be thematic, and it's going to have a whole bunch of stuff ready for it. So every time I do stream, it's not just going to be, here's Drew working, it's going to be, here's Drew presenting, you know, X, like a lesson plan. Like, I'll show step-by-step procedures on how to do a certain thing, like a sculpting lesson. Or another one where I'm just doing painting. But it's going to be like a weekly thing, not this drop-in weekday stuff. I think I'll do it on the weekends. Yeah. It'll be a weekend stream instead of these every weekday things. It's just not working for me. Sorry, I had to find out the hard way. And maybe we'll get to see more of you on the weekend, and you won't have to go off to do dinner. Dinner and a movie. I'm glad you're supporting me in this. I hate to disappoint anybody. It should be better for all. Also, I don't know. I mean, this is for me, but I might be doing it in such a way that I can monetize it. So I'll be using like music that's not going to get copyright claims. Right now, this music might have a copyright claim on it. I don't know. I'm being rather, you know, sloppy about it. So I'd make special arrangements so that it doesn't have copyright claims and other little things. Well, are you streaming on the weekends, Alan? I'm just using my soft tool here to just sort of get all the general shapes at once. This is not the ideal way of working. But in a situation like this, where I need to like get a sense of the vision of the figure, it's the best approach for me. Oh, then you'll be free for the weekend. Yeah, I'm gonna do a weekend stream of some kind. I don't know if it should be Saturdays or Sundays. Do you have an opinion on this, Alan? Should it be Saturdays or Sundays? Which do you think would be the better crowd? More fun for people. More useful for people. You think Sundays, huh? Sunday stream. This blaster dwarf sculpting is crazy, right? I'm just gonna like keep going round and round circles on this putty all at once until I hone in on a look and feel for the dwarf and get the details in. Round and round all over the place. I'll be changing tools soon. This one's starting to like come to its limits with my needs here. For my scheduled meeting with my doctor tomorrow. Oh well. Yep, I'm starting to go around in circles more because I'm using the same tool too much. I'm gonna switch it, I promise. I just have to make sure I've got the volumes balanced out mostly. And all the seams covered up. The little breaks in the putty. or bits of putty collide. Once the putty starts to dry after a while, you can't really patch those up. They just stay separate. You have to take care of it while the putty is still fresh. I'm not sure when I'm going to start the new schedule, though. Might be sooner than I'd like. I've got other forces in my life that are pressing. I mentioned before that we're looking to possibly move later this spring, and that's going to demand a lot. We have to leave San Francisco. It's eating us alive. I make a good living doing miniature sculpting, but you wouldn't know it looking at my bank account after everything's said and done, because this town is just so expensive, particularly the cost of our house. I haven't been able to, like, visit my family much or do things for my mother. It's just no good. Living in San Francisco is to live beyond my means. Hey, Frank. Well, I have been waffling on buying a house all of my life. I never really felt confident enough to, like, say, this is where I'm going to be and actually buy a house. Half my life I haven't really had the ability, the financing to do it. Now my wife, however, now I'm married, like our fourth anniversary a couple months back, and she is now determined to get a house. So I'm pretty much kind of going along with her on this. So it's going to be her choice about where to move to, her choice of what house to get. Hell, for a while last year, I was thinking about building a house for her. Something modest. We have similar tastes in a lot of ways. But the point is that she's the one who's calling the shots on this. I make enough money, but yeah, in the end, it's gonna be her castle. That's fine by me. As long as she gives me a nice room to sculpt in. It's nerve-wracking though, because the same fears and forces that have, like, kept me from wanting to make a choice about where to live this all my life, still play havoc with my brain when she starts talking about what she wants to do, and I'm like, I don't know. And the best that I can do is just, you know, keep a cork in it. Just trust her. Just trust her and go with it. She's got pretty good taste, though. I think I'm in good hands if I just, like, relax and let things happen. This, of course, means there's going to be a hiccup in my my streaming this year, so probably late spring you're gonna see me not streaming for a while. When I come back, people are gonna be like, where were you? And I'll be like, I was moving. And it won't be good morning from San Francisco anymore either. Hey, Yeah, that's the other thing, though. Because I've moved around a lot over the years. I have lived in, I think, 15 different places in the course of my life. This house I'm living in here is one of the longest stays in one place that I've experienced since I was a teenager in my parents' house. How to have experience superficially making a home out of any place I move to, but to really dig in and create a home for myself is not a skill I have. Closer and closer to a blaster dwarf. A blaster scrapper. Do we want to put a trim on these pauldrons? I think I do. Alan put trim on one of the pauldrons, but not both of them. Let me see what happens when I put trim on it here. I know, I'm just like drawing a line and pulling it out. I'm trying to see if I can create these dwarves organically by just like tweaking the details right out of the putty all at once. Need to leave already? Sorry, man, I have to go. What? Did the kids come and jump on you and say, movie time, movie time? Oh, you have such a terrible, hard life, Alan. I feel so bad for you. You're cursed. You cursed yourself, man. I hope you have fun. We'll be here for another a good hour and a half from now. If you should come back. Rabbit who pooped chocolate candy. What rabbit doesn't poop chocolate candy? Tool for this, but man. The Easter Bunny. Not Easter yet! Now I just did that to get the eyes started, but that is not, those are not real eyes. Maybe on the helmet, but this isn't the helmet. We're trying to do the face. Excuse me, I have to lean back and pinch into this bit. I have to figure out this face real quick. Another thing, the posture of leaning forward and trying to get an angle for you guys to see my work really interferes with my productivity. I wish it didn't. I was hoping that I would get used to it after a few weeks or months, but it's just no good. Hey, Alan. Have fun. I'm sure you will. I need to see what happens if I pull this out, just like in the art. Do it equally on both sides. Here and there. I have a tendency to make the legs a little small compared to the bodies, I think. That's unintentional. I want to be equal. I think it's the focus on the pauldrons and giving them big shoulders. Thomas Foss once told me that even though the camera isn't really zoomed in very much on my work, he says it's still good to see how I use my tools. I have to, and it, that it's instructive. I didn't think that would be the case, but I'll just have to trust his word. do like to be helpful. I was talking to some people, and there's this thing I came across online. Some of you out there might know that I'm like experimenting with some new medication because I might have, probably have ADHD, and I just never, you know, took care of it medically. Never had it attended to. And my new work with my ADHD symptoms, I've discovered that a thing that's prevalent among in many people who have ADHD is imposter syndrome. This is news to me. I didn't know that was a thing that might... I just never knew much about it. I heard the word before, but I don't know what it was. And it turns out that part of my discomfort in streaming with you guys has to do with this, the fact that I am never satisfied with showing you what I'm doing because I feel like I'm lying to you. I'm not. I'm sitting here sculpting with you guys. I just don't feel like I'm showing you what you need to see. Because I'm actually an imposter. I'm not really a miniature sculptor. Just pretend to be one. I've half joked this kind of stuff before, but I never realized that it might be like a mental condition for me. I'm like trying to focus on my work here, and all I can think right now as I'm doing this is, oh damn it, Frank V. Punk can't see what I'm doing with this nose. Doesn't see me working on the nostrils, because he can't. This is all my fault. Why am I wasting Frank's time? I just didn't think it was a mental condition, you know? Or that it could be. I mean, that's the reason that I sculpt miniatures for a living. That's why I'm here. Because I really just couldn't cope with, some would call it real life. Out in the world, doing a job with other humans. My ADHD tendencies would get in the way. Right now I'm trying to get this head. This is a dwarf's head, but it has to be, because most of the dwarf heads are really robust, you know? And I have to create this dwarf face in a way that's, it looks robust, but it's also small enough that it fits within this, I don't know, what would you call this armor that's covering up the lower part of his face? It has a name. Gorget? I don't know. How many dwarves in total? I can't quite remember. I think the number, it's not just dwarves, there's a few extra figures, character figures, and maybe a robot or two. There's some robot designs that Alan is working on right now. This is supposed to be a cutter heavy laser bot. And I like this design. I'm looking forward to trying it out. But there's only gonna be, I think, in total, when the whole order is done, maybe 15 or 17 pieces. And the majority of them are going to be dwarves. It's not going to be a large set. It's going to be a very tidy little set. A lucky number. I seem to remember Thomas Foss was excited about the lucky number in the set. He sort of like wants to allude to the Lord of the Rings, the party of dwarves, and Gandalf, and Frodo, the halfling. So we might have a halfling in the set as well. I'm pretty sure we will. Pretty sure that's part of the package. Sort of. It's gonna be a total package. You know, I'm not gonna say too much more about it right now. I leave the rest in Thomas Foss's hands for now. It might even be some sort of a what do you call it? It might be a Kickstarter to get it financed. But for now, we're just sculpting a few figures. Were you here when I was describing what the theme for the set is? It's Space Dwarf Scrappers. They're an elite team of dwarves it's sort of like Space Hulk, where they go and they raid derelict ships in space looking for artifacts. It's kind of a cross between a sort of a boarding raiding crew and mechanics ready to cut pieces out of a bulkhead and take it back with them. Petty little missions. Excuse me while I focus on the dwarf's face for a little bit. Make him look a little bit evil by happenstance, but at least that he looks like a dwarf. Dwarf eyes, nostrils. Yeah, something like that. My proposal to Thomas Foss and Alan when they're putting together the designs for this project was that everything the dwarves use for combat is also their tools for getting the job done. That was my suggestion. An update. Together. I want the cowl to be less apparent though. I think I've made it slightly the wrong size. I'm not sure. Yeah, I gotta pull it down a little bit. I mean, I'm looking at the artwork, and it's not supposed to cover up that much of the face. I have a tendency to tilt. You know, if you have, like, something, a line of some kind, like a waist belt, driving around the circumference of the volume of the figure, if it's at the waist or around the neck, I have a tendency to bring the back up higher than the front, which typically works. But it's not quite working out here for this bit of armor that's covering up half his face. It needs to be more lower in the back. I'll definitely be adding a few more details to the head. This is not sufficient, but it's a good start. Oh, maybe I can get the head done on that right now, here and now. Biggest trick. Oh, jeez. Sure. I gotta hold this like this. Excuse me. The biggest trick here is making the nose large and yet still within the circumference of the owl. That's the thing. It's like Thomas Foss wants big noses and stuff, just like the artwork for Paul Bonner and things. But then he gives me this design, which calls for a small nose. Really? I can do it. Is his beard sticking through the armor, or is that a respirator? It's a respirator. You don't see his beard on this one. Yeah, these are just cables. You know, somewhat like the cables that you see on old Beaky Space Marines. Something like that. Well, I've done everything I can with the face for now. I'll add a little bit more putty and stuff to enhance the nose and the cheekbones and stuff. After the fact. I'm just gonna focus on trying to get the armor shapes right for now. Let's see if I can share my productivity with you guys. In some ways, this dwarf figure, the blaster, is supposed to be inspired by the original space dwarf, the very first one that Citadel made. This guy, but plenty of distinctive differences that set him apart and makes him part of this line. But he's supposed to be a spiritual cousin to that one, a bunch of things. Yeah, I gotta create some sort of a stable weekly schedule that can include a weekly stream. Part of the reason that I have to do this is because, proof's in the pudding, I found out that doing the streaming is good for my business, but not in the way I'd hoped. Instead of making more sales of my products in my store, I'm getting more commissions. And even though a good chunk of those commissions, people are saying, yeah, please, stream the productivity of the job. I'm finding as I'm going forward that's just not adding up for most of them. It's hard for me to describe what makes a job something that I feel that I could stream and when streaming isn't working. I'm coming along pretty okay today with you guys working on this space, on these space dwarves. But generally, space dwarves isn't something that I can really readily stream. It's something about the design. I really need to take my time offline, personally. However, Nightmare Games recent order, the trolls that Nightmare Games has ordered me to do, based on the artwork from Port Vilet, you might remember the trolls from the gnomes series of books from the 80s. Those trolls are just begging to be stream sculpted. For me, at least. And it's not like one order is preferred over the other personally, or that one order is more valuable. It's just a matter of which ones I can share. I don't know, it's hard to describe. I'm definitely going to be coming back into this Blaster Dwarf with a fresh X-Acto blade and doing a little bit of shaving on the armor to make it look really crisp. Right now, it has a bit of a, I don't know, kind of a gummy look to it. And I want to clean it up. He's also going to get some sort of a backpack, I'm sure. Power pack or something on the back of his armor. So all this is going to get filled up with something. I believe the order calls for two of this guy. One with the helmet on, one with the helmet off. It's such a small scale, it's going to be hard to get the angles right. Which angles do you mean? The angles in the cameras? That's all I ever think about. I can't get an angle on this. Yeah. That's the other thing. That's why I have to make it a tighter format situation, something specialized. Just sitting here letting you watch me sculpt isn't enough. I have to have a set, like, in development with pieces to show, lots to talk about. It has to be a production, it can't just be an eavesdrop. Because I can't get the cameras to work on miniature sculpting eavesdropping, so to speak. It's gotta be formal, it needs to be structured. Oh, I might need a new camera. Maybe I should just strap it to my forehead so you can see what I'm doing. And it's like attached to my head, and I can like look around and everything. Everywhere I look, there it is. Maybe. You can get like doodad head straps you can put on your temple and like attach the camera right there. Are you ready to see me with like a head strap and a camera stuck to the side of my head? I don't know, I think it might get people a little motion sick. This is an idea that I had contemplated and discarded like 2 months ago, and now I'm entertaining it again. Alright, that's two down. This is good, we're getting like one dwarf per hour. Let's do a third, shall we? Mocha Minis, I'm trying to think what she does. I don't think I've tuned in to see what she does. Okay. This one's gonna be a clearer. But you know, when I paint miniatures, I can hold still better. Because I don't have to turn it around in a lot of different ways to get the paint on the figure. I can do that on the tabletop pretty easily compared to miniature sculpting. Miniature painting, I can do it right on the table. But sculpting requires a lot more from me. Maybe I have to transfer my Aby's epoxy into smaller containers to help keep them fresh longer. They normally don't work in volumes large enough to go through a pair of, 4-pound tubs, which is one of the package sizes they sell. It's just a little bit too slow for me, and the part B, I believe it's part B. Yeah, the part B on the Aby's epoxy tends to dry up on me towards the bottom of the bin. If I was using smaller tubs, I could put some of them in the freezer and it won't go off on me. Hours when my nose is itching a lot. Maybe it's just as well that the Skull and Crown guys aren't here with me right now. They just distract me. Yeah, so I might close out the month of January with this regular schedule, and then in February I'll switch to the weekend schedule. But my weekend stream will be longer. With longer streams, I'll be able to straddle time zones. Get people who are like available at different times of the day in different parts of the world. This and see what happens. Add some more to the back. Need support. Dwarf armor ideas going here. And yeah, I know, this dwarf doesn't have a beard or a mustache or anything. That'll change in time. For now, we're just worrying about the body. I believe the clearers are meant to be bare armed. I mean, these are dwarves, so you can't really see much of their arms. You're gonna do a muscle-bound dwarf. For the most part, all you're gonna see is a muscle-bound elbow. I'll do my best, but it's hard to show things like your bicep and stuff when you're a dwarf. Your arms are just so short. I'm just gonna go round and round circles with this one. Something comes to the fore. I mean, I've got Aaron's artwork here in front of me. But what I really am looking at here are like a arrangement of concepts. I think the implication is that I mix and match a lot of this. Work with what works. Ugh. Muscular elbow. Also, I'm left-handed, and it's unfortunate that I have all my cameras on my left side, right where I need my arm. I'm just gonna go round and round circles on this guy for the next hour until he's done. That's how exciting this episode's gonna be. And I'm just gonna sit like this, and then I'll occasionally, like, do sneak peeks like this throughout the hour. And that's the shape of today's stream. As I say, I think we need a better format for further streams from me. And they're gonna have to be, gonna have to be some weekend streams. In fact, I'm having a hard time sculpting up here on the table. I really like to be down here above my chest. Oh, come on. See, that's not so bad. This way you actually get to see me doing something. figure out where all the volumes are. Below the figure. This figure is going to be carrying two hammers. One over his right shoulder here, and the other one held forth. Do I drink a lot of wine, or do you get a lot of donations? What, wine donations? I'll take wine. I drink wine. In fact, I'm not very big on alcohol, so wine is my preferred drink. One nice glass of wine is all it takes. Red, usually. White gives me gas. So later on, I'll include a button in my stream so that people can donate bottles of wine to me. Oh, the corks! Yeah, these are wine corks. It's a usual practice. A lot of sculptors will use wine corks for makeshift rigs. I have a lot of them laying around now. See? Look. All different shapes and sizes. Just get a cork, put a weight on the bottom, like a washer, seal the top with some putty, usually some putty that's got a lot of hardener in it so it's really stiff, sand it flat, good to go. And you just drill holes down into it with a hand drill. Your armatures can be mounted into it. Size comparison, looking good. I'm liking this. This guy's coming along now. All at once. I just wish my nose would stop itching. Excuse me. 18 figures. That's 18 bottles of wine. I haven't drank that much wine in my life. Dude. It's not that hard to get corks. And you don't really need to drink all the wine to get the corks. You can go to a lot of bars serve wine and just ask them for their corks and they'll give you a whole big box of them. Here you go, take them away, get out of my face. You do the same thing with dental tools sometimes. Talk to your dentist, find out that he's got some old tools that he can't use on teeth but you can use on sculpting just fine. Drank that much wine? 18 bottles is not a lot. I don't know. Maybe it's because I'm in my 50s. If I haven't had 18 bottles of wine in my life by now, something's wrong. Switch tools soon. Not just yet, but soon. If I could figure out how to sculpt on cases if beer, I will send them your There's all kinds of rigs, you know. I know you're just joking, but I'm saying, you know, wine corks like I'm using are just one way of doing it. There's lots of other ways. I remember experimenting with a technique that Bobby Jackson employed, and he's not the only one, where sculptors will, you take a block of wood, a tiny block of wood, and you cut it in half, or just, you know, two pieces of wood that are exactly the same size, and then you have a little bit of hardware, like a screw and a wing nut and some washers, to create a little tiny mini vise. And then you simply, vise grip the wires or the tab or whatever you have of that miniature down between the blocks of wood and tighten the vise on it and clamps it in place. It works very well for Bobby and a lot of other sculptors. And you don't have to drink any wine. Also, there's now those new miniature painting clamps that they make that seem to be pretty popular. I haven't used one myself, but I don't see why it can't be used for sculpting too. Is all over the place because there's no undersculpt here, it's just raw wire, so the putty kind of travels around it a little bit. I don't know, maybe when I change the tool it'll work better. Right now it's not working for me. Gotta be careful I don't get scale creep on this. It gets a bit big. I don't want to get oversized. Smooth out all the shapes that I've established. I'm not going to worry about the wrists and the fists much at this stage. The gauntlets. I'm going to focus on the arms. Get those muscular elbows just right. The reason that I didn't, that I stopped using Bobby's technique, and I gave it a fair shake, it wasn't for me though, because the way I operate, I use a metal cooker over here by my side, you know, a light bulb inside of a tin space that amplifies the heat and accelerates the cure time for a lot of the figures, so I can rotate through it more. What would take 2 hours to dry, it takes only 30 minutes. And I need that. But if I use those rigs that Bobby showed me how to use, the ones with the wing nuts, the hardware gets hot. And so I can reach inside of a cooker to grab a figure that's been sitting under a light bulb for a good hour or so, and it starts to burn my fingertips. I touch in the wrong place. Wine corks are insulated. They don't get hot. You can leave it in there forever. There's no problem. Oh, I'm not even in the screen. Excuse me. See, there I go again. I'll be able to get these muscles on this arm while it's just putty and wire and no undersculpt. Keep it stable. I'll try. Hey, Flora's phone, how's it going? It's an easygoing, no thrills day here in my studio. Making sure I don't get scale creep on my dwarves. How do they compare with old fashioned figures? That's a pretty good size. Okay, we're doing good. I'm trying. I wasn't really feeling it with trying to do these dwarves incrementally. Little tiny detail by little tiny detail. So instead, I'm trying to go after just creating as much of the figure as possible all in one go. So small. Did you use your mandrake done? Florist, you're working on mandrake? I don't know. This doesn't feel right. I'm gonna cut off some of this putty. It seems like it's too much. Was that a, oh, that was a mandrake? I hadn't noticed. I was so fixated on the sculpting angle. These space dwarves are really kicking my butt. It's hard to describe how excited I am to do the space dwarves, but how effortless the Portville trolls are coming along. And when it comes to actually streaming my productivity, I'm best off streaming with something that's effortless, so I'm not as distracted. Tomorrow's stream will be the Portville Trolls then. Give these guys a little break and get back to them on Thursday. Sorry. These arms. I'm just gonna create the understructure for the arms. This is no good. I'm going around in circles. A little bit more than I intend to. Focus on the details of the armor here. I'm making up as I go along. Oh, yeah. We were just talking about that. I have a real hard time with my camera work. Focusing on on miniatures while using a camera is... doesn't really work well. I was just commenting on how I'm gonna have to change my format and just do some big, specialized events on weekends rather than daily streams. Because it's just no good. Trying to get people to see me working on my miniatures on a daily basis is very tricky. Because in my work, I don't hold still. I just don't hold still. At least with your watercolor, you just have things laying on the table, though. At least that part is stable. For a while, I had this camera positioned directly above the table looking down. But then I couldn't leave the table and lean back to do my sculpting. I don't know. I should appreciate how much good my stream has done my business in terms of getting me a whole bunch of new commissions for the season. that I didn't expect to get. Just use some crisscross patterns is really slowing me down. These designs look so, oh, I don't know. Can I save this in 30 minutes? Skull and Crown has arrived. Hey, see us working on these dwarves, pulling the details out all at once in a lot of cases. I was just bitching and moaning about how similar a lot of this armor is looking. Kind of reminds me of the armor on, what do you call it, the Dracula armor in the Gary Oldman version of the medieval Dracula. Similar in texture. I mean, ideally, if you when you dress somebody in like clothing and you want it to look like it's slapped on and not just some uniform, you want to mix the patterns. And we're not getting, I'm not getting a good mixture of patterns here. It's becoming a uniform, and kind of a strange uniform at that. So I'm thinking about, yeah, ignoring some of this. This is no good. I'm going to make these knee pads don't have the vertical lines on them. It's just no good. Are we doing chainmail too? I forgot about the chainmail. Knee pads should be hard armor. Well, talk to Aaron, because he gave us a lot of knee pads with padding on them, like the kind of padding you get from cricket matches. Oh, chainmail. Do I want to just do chainmail here? We totes the old school guys had them, and we want to help convey the Hobbit feel. And it's a shame that Aaron isn't here to talk about this. I'm all over the place with this clearer. I was just mentioning to the other guys here that I'm intending to change my stream format. I can't do this daily thing. I'm gonna do like a special 5-hour weekend stream or something, themed with some sort of constructive thing, like, you know, instructional on how to sculpt something. Or, you know, building a tank or some special thing. Not just eavesdropping on my productivity in the studio. Look at the Imperial Squat Standard Bearers, for example. Potbellies and chainmail work. One of my problems is that I don't have any space dwarfs. I've never collected space dwarfs. I don't have a single one with me. These legs are too robust. I gotta bring this in. Imperial Squat Standard Bearer. Do I have an image of Imperial Squat Standard Bearer on him? Not that. Yeah, that's the thing about the space dwarf command group, is that they don't have any hard armor on them almost. They're pretty much just soft fabric and everything, and leather boots and so forth. And that makes it easier when you're dealing with a compact form. You just add a few wrinkles and boom, you're done. Bob's your uncle. When you start doing segmented armor and stuff, then you're dealing with the lengths of the limbs. I don't know. I'm gonna pull this up. This is too low. Doesn't work for me. It slows the figure down. Bells and Waters has got you. Elton came back. Hey, Elton. Let's see what he found. Oop. Taking a look. Oh yeah, there you go. Candy. Better picture than the one I've got on the table. Oh, by the way, the clears are supposed to be bare-armed, right? Muscular arms? Mostly they are shooters. Shooters? The clearers? I thought the clearers were the one. Okay, the guys with the wielding two hammers. They're the clearers, right? Old one? I thought this represented clearer. Oh, okay. I'll just make a figure look cool then. It's 12:40. So, what shall we do? Clearers, heavy. Okay. Clearers are heavy weapons, aka clearing the room. So the guy with the hammer is also a cutter. Okay. I thought the cutters were these guys with the glaives and the. It says cutters on this sheet, so I just took it that this is the type of figure that's a cutter. And they all have cutting objects on them. Okay. Darn. Well, now I'm making one more cutter. I meant to just make one. No biggie. Let's do some chainmail, huh? In the last 20 minutes of the stream. Starting to get a vision of what it is I'm trying to do here. Gotta make these legs feel a little smaller though. Can't let them scale. You add too much putty to a pair of dwarf legs, you tend to lose control. Thanks for dropping in, Elton. A bonus, Elton. Scissors to remove putty, and it's just cleaner. You can snip it right off and it doesn't interfere with the rest of the figure. All right, let's do some let's try to get some uh did this. Excuse me. Did you tell Aaron that he should use chainmail in some of his designs? I can't do my job in stream. Period. I'll keep trying for the next couple weeks, but starting February, I'm just gonna do weekend streams with some special events, like painting something or a special behind the scenes project, like sculpting my tank out of plasticard. My regular or an instructional, like, here's how you sculpt faces. Step one, step two, step three, something like that. But just eavesdrop on Drew's productivity in the studio, this isn't working. I gave it a fair shot, you can't say I didn't. But I can't deal with all these distractions. Not in a productive way. It's too much. I wouldn't mind if I wasn't being paid to do this stuff. But I am, so I do. There, chainmail. Much better. This dwarf does not look like a dwarf until I get a beard or something on him. Shall we do that? Nope, can't. Putty's gone. It's not sticky enough. Let's just try to fine-tune these legs so they looked articulated and will work. I'm doing boots here. Just regular leather boots now. I'm not working on the back detail, but I will straighten out the shape a little bit. Some of this is going to be removed. And I'm not sure if he gets a backpack. Hmm. Sorry. I can't do this. Any suggestions out there for certain themes for 6-hour streams on a weekend? As opposed to what I said here, it's like eavesdropping my productivity, or my standard productivity in the studio. I don't want to do that anymore. I don't want to impose having to entertain the energy I have to put into entertaining and putting things on camera onto my paid jobs. So I have to do project streams. You know, like you would. Something entertaining and specific and structured. Okay, I don't know either. I'm still putting it together. Has reached just the right point where I can do some muscle work on these arms after all. But I dare not. I don't know. I'll do it on the right arm. This dwarf is going to look stupid until he gets his beard on. Oof. Well, we got to see Alan Skull and Crown for a little bit. Not everybody all at once. Lots of good faces showed up. No. Chainmail texture is going to be recontextualized, you know, from medieval to something more modern once more modern gear is thrown onto the details. Like some sort of a sensor pack on his belt instead of a sword and so forth. Well, that's where we are for now. Here, I'll show you. That's what we did today. No great shakes, but three dwarves coming along. That's their fundamental shapes. And I think we'll get a fourth one in there as well. And then we'll tighten up those four and get their details crisp. And that'll be a set of dwarves for the order. And we'll do another four in another batch later. So that's it for today. Like I say, sculpting while streaming. Tried it for a while, tried it for a good 3.5 months or so. Going on 4 months, I guess, yeah. But it doesn't work for me. I need to be private with the development of a lot of my orders. I can't stream. Before, when I began the stream, I was complaining that, oh, I can't stream what I'm sculpting for my clients because a lot of them will have a problem with NDAs and so forth. Well, that's still true to an extent, but doesn't seem to be a really big problem. Lots of people came out of the woodwork in the past couple months and said, yeah, stream the work for me. Great. But now that I'm in it, I'm realizing it just doesn't work. The handling, the stream, and the camera, and where the camera's pointing, it's just too distracting. I need to focus on my job. So I'm not going to quit streaming all out, but next month it's going to be a different kind of schedule. It's going to be just 4 streams a week, a month it seems, weekend streams, longer streams. I think it was Skull and Crown who was, you know, encouraged me to pull back from 4 and 5 hour streams, just make them tight little 3 hour streams like I've just done. He's right. Don't want to burn myself out. But for a big weekend stream, I think I'll just do it. It's 4, 5, 6 hour streams. Stream till I drop. On Sundays, it seems. That's, I don't know. Somebody said that Sundays are a good idea. I think they're probably right. Yeah, that'll be happening in February, it seems. Changing my schedule in February to weekend streams only. And, I'm open for some suggestions as to the kind of content, because they're going to be specialty streams, sculpting instructions on a particular type of thing. Maybe large-scale sculpture. Maybe I'll demonstrate some, maquette sculpture for a change. Haven't done that in a while. You know, or maybe... Hell, maybe I'll do a stream where I show you how to sculpt a life-size bust. I got the gear for it, and I got the skills. You haven't seen me do that before, have you? Yeah, there's all kinds of opportunities. The point is that I can't tie my stream to my productivity in the studio for miniature sculpting. It's just not adding up. Anyway, like I said, you can't say I didn't try. Thank you very much for coming around and watching me on this slow, easygoing, foggy, dwarf day. I will be doing, some trolls for, what do you call it again? Nightmare Games tomorrow. And then on the following day, on Thursday, we're going right back into these dwarves. These three, plus a fourth one, and their details. And their weapons. That's the plan. Alright. Dragons are the bane of your existence. Scales. Yeah. Alright, so let me just take a look, see if we've got somebody we can go and, raid. Probably not. I don't have too many people that I follow on a regular basis. But let me see who's live. That would be worth a rating. Oh, hey! My boys over at Dwarven Forge. Who wants to go check out what they're doing at Dwarven Forge? Let's see.
Entrance. Steam would flow out of it.
I don't know. What do you guys think? Dwarven Forge Live. How do I do this? Raid. /. Okay, Skull and Crown. Thanks for coming by. Maybe not Dwarven Forge. Maybe I should go to my friend Animar, who seems to be still sculpting. Yeah. She's working on a miniature, actually. She usually does maquettes. Nope, wrong one. Let's try this again. Is it / raid? How's this go? Yeah, / raid. Four of us. Here we go. Take care, guys. See ya.